Hello. I am going to discuss today in continuing with our series on Indian Forest Service, and right now we are in the very first stage of this series. In my previous video we discussed about the basic things about the Indian Forest Service or IFS, and continuing the series, in this second video I am going to talk about why you should think of joining the Indian Forest Service. There are technical reasons behind it and there are practical considerations behind it. I am going to guide you step by step what are the things that should motivate you to get into the Indian Forest Service. My name is Dr. Abhishek Kumar and I am here to guide you about Indian Forest Service examination preparation. So as you can see here, I have organized your reasons into five parts. These green boxes that you see here are individually the reasons why you should think of joining the Indian Forest Service. I am going to enlarge it and I am going to describe each point so that you actually have a good set of reasons. If you are eligible to take this exam, then you must be taking this examination. So one reason is that it's an All India service. What does it imply? There are different points. Second, you will help in establishing the environment development balance. Third, you will be spending a great deal of time in natural surrounding. Fourth, you will actually be bringing about positive changes in the society and especially in the lives of the most marginalized people. And fifth is a practical consideration that it is relatively an easier examination to crack. Relatively easier, some of you may not be very convinced, because any competitive examination is an intense affair. You need to prepare, you need to beat the competition to secure a seat for yourself. Still, when you compare it with the civil service exam, it is an easier challenge to overcome. So let us start step by step. The first and biggest reason why any young person should think of joining the Indian Forest Service is the very fact that it is an All India service. What's an All India service? I discussed in the first part of this video series. When I was discussing about Indian Forest Service, I touched the essentials of All India service, and you can recall from our previous discussion that Indian Forest Service is one of the three All India services. The other two are Indian Administrative Service and Indian Police Service. Among the three All India services, Indian Forest Service is the youngest All India service. It was instituted in 1966. It is having a long history behind, but I would not go into that. If you are interested in that, you must be watching the first video of this series where I have spoken about the history of this service also. Now, an All India service, what does it mean to you? Why should it motivate, why should it inspire you to join the Indian Forest Service? The sheer fact that it is an All India service. So let us see the points one after one. The first point, obviously, that you can see on the board, that the job has got extremely high social recognition and respectability. It is a thing that's been established by psychologists that the first and biggest motivator whenever someone decides to be in a line of career, the most important thing is, what's the social recognition, what's the respect I will command. Lot of people immaturely think that money might be the first motivator. It is not. When pilots were offered higher salary, but they were asked not to fly the plane but rather serve the passengers sitting in the cabin, what normally the flight attendants do, the pilots refused despite the fact that they were being paid higher salary. So your first motivation, whether you realize this or not, is what is the social status you would be commanding. And I'm not talking about the so-called notion of power. That notion of power you should just throw away from your mind when you are starting to prepare for this examination, okay? It is a service. You are here to serve. It is Indian Forest Service. So the powers are given to implement certain policies, to enforce certain rules, so that you can serve the country, you can serve the society better. So I'm not talking about power, but when you are in a job, you are in a career, you certainly expect that the society recognizes your effort, recognizes what you are doing, recognizes what you are contributing, and respects you for that. You will get ample of all this in an All India service, and Indian Forest Service is no exception. Next is diversity of postings. So of course you will be a DFO if you join the Indian Forest Service. So you will become Divisional Forest Officer, you will be promoted through the ranks, and you can even go to the rank of PCCF. But that thing apart, you will also be heading a number of bodies, let us say the pollution control boards at the state level, pollution control board at the central level, then conservation related bodies, for example, National Tiger Conservation Authority, various zoo in the country. They are managed, their administrative oversight is with the Central Zoo Authority. The directors of different zoo are also Indian Forest Service officer. Then the field officers who manage, who administer national parks, tiger reserves, they are all Indian Forest Service officer. So you will be having diversity of postings. And later I will talk certain other dimension also, but a little later. Then it is a field job. Being a field job means it brings with itself its own set of challenges, lot of challenges. Every day in the field, in any part of the country, will demand you to solve certain problem that you have not faced earlier. Every single day enriches you as a person, strengthens you as a person, teaches you something, and you grow as a person, as a professional, and there is no such thing which can contribute as big in your personality development as the field experience. And this is exactly what the Indian Forest Service will be giving you. It's a field job that way. Next thing is that later in your career, you contribute to policy making. So most of the Indian Forest Service officials in the later half of their career, when they come for the central government deputation, they are already having the seniority to be a part of policy formulation team, rule formulation team, etc. Understand that you are solely not going to make a policy that is going to be implemented for the entire country. So don't think that you are going to make the policy, but yes, you are going to be a part of the team that's going to make the policy. What kind of policies? Forest policy, various types of action plan like wildlife action plan, biodiversity action plan, a number of pollution abatement plans, then various rules, for example, coastal regulation zone rule, ecologically sensitive area rules. These all things are actually formulated by Indian Forest Service officials when they are senior, they are posted with Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So extremely satisfying affair when something that you contribute to, something that you do, is actually used as a template to run the affairs of the country. Further, you will also be getting opportunity to serve in other ministries and departments with the central government. A good number of Indian Forest Service officials, they find senior posts at the level of Joint Secretary, etc., in a number of other ministries than Environment, Forest and Climate Change. And that is going to further enrich your professional profile, professional acumen, by increasing the diversity of exposure. Last but not the least, like any other All India service, you will be having an opportunity of higher education, different types of training by going overseas. Not only that, you will be actually the person who will be representing India in a number of environment, forest, climate related negotiations. So that kind of international exposure will also be there when you are a part of Indian Forest Service. Frankly, after knowing this much, most of you should not even need to watch the rest of the video. This should be reason enough. Had I been in your position, if someone would have told me all these things, I would have stopped the video and I would have started to prepare for IFS. That is how it is. But chalo, let me give you certain more reasons. So come here. And it sounds very theoretical, but I'll tell you why it is not theoretical. You will help in maintaining the environment development balance. For the first time, the world woke up to this reality of environment development balance in 1971, when the United Nations for the first time organized United Nations Conference on Environment and Development at Stockholm, that we know as a Stockholm meet. So, a Stockholm conference onwards, the economies of the world and the international society as a whole has constantly struggled to increase the level of development so that we can secure better quality of living for maximum number of people, but at the same time safeguarding the environmental health. Because it is now clear, more clear than at any point of time in our history, that the environmental backlash, they undo all the development that we might have done. So agricultural technology increases agricultural output, but a bad year with rainfall, too much of rainfall or too less of rainfall, will destroy the crop. So agricultural technology is a development, but environmental backlash destroying the crop is undoing that development. Similarly, lot of coastal areas have come up with great economic infrastructure. Lot of coastal cities across the world, they are actually the powerful centers of civilization, economy and all that. But at the same time, these coastal cities face the risk of submergence once the ocean level, sea level rises. And again, the environmental backlash is threatening the development. As Indian Forest Service officer, you will be on the forefront of balancing development and the environment. And today, economies across the world are struggling to achieve this balance. And you as a professional will be one of the most meaningful professional for the country's developmental process. So the burning need of the present time and climate change effects are already visible. Even in India, we can see the climate change effects. So this is the time that young and talented people come forward and they give their time, energy, passion in this field. Next, this relates to you, your quality of life. That as an Indian Forest Service officer, you will be spending a great deal of time in nature's surrounding. So if you are someone who likes quiet and natural surrounding, this is the job for you. If you do not enjoy the hustle and bustle of the big cities, this is the job for you. And it is even more wonderful if you have an interest in the wildlife, interest in outdoor activities like trekking, hiking and all that. So this is the job awaiting you. So all the nature enthusiasts, outdoor enthusiasts, wildlife enthusiasts, even the bird watchers, for all of you, this is the job to get into. Let me come to the social contribution part, very, very important. You will bring about positive changes in the life of marginalized people. Who are the most marginalized people? Among them, you have people who live on the fringes of the forest, who live inside the forest. They are completely cut off from the development that we have been able to achieve as a nation. They have hardly tasted the fruits of that development. They still live in an extremely primitive manner. But if you are a well-meaning Indian Forest Service officer, if you are someone who takes his job with a religious sense of purpose, then you can actually bring a lot of positive difference in their life. As DFO, you will be working closely with the tribals. And lot of your activities, for example, the joint forest management program, which we have been running since late 1980s, they will empower the forest-based communities, the tribals and other traditional forest dwellers. You will be making a lot of positive change. JFM has brought economic empowerment to the forest-dwelling communities. And not only that, it has brought a tremendous amount of traditional conservation knowledge in the management of forest. So both ways, the forest department gains, the native community gain, and you as the Indian Forest Service official will be leading all this transformative exercise. Does that inspire you? If yes, I'm actually happy. And there are many projects and even the routine management activities, they will be generating employment for the forest dwelling communities. So these are some of the reasons why you should aspire to join the Indian Forest Service. And mind it, I have not yet spoken about the very handsome pay scale that the All India Service officials get, extremely good set of perks that you will be entitled to. These are the things which are anyway there in the public domain, and being a talented young person, there will be no dearth of good money fetching jobs with you. But All India Services are in their own league, so I'm not talking about the salary perks and all that. You, if you are interested in that, you can always check that out on a lot of government sources. But these are the changes, these are the reasons which should actually affect you at a deeper level than merely the monetary part. Now the last reason is actually a practical consideration. Read it carefully. Indian Forest Service examination is relatively easier to crack. There is no competition that is easy. That's the disclaimer. But having given you this disclaimer, let us understand that when you compare it with the civil service exam, this is a relatively easier examination. We at Evolution have been given training, giving coaching for both civil service and Indian Forest Service. We have seen the candidates clearing the Indian Forest Service, such a wonderful All India Service, with relatively less effort. So why not take advantage of this factor also? So what are the things which come here? Let's say the first two things. The exam is eligible, you are eligible to take this exam. The exam is open only to science, applied science and engineering graduate. So science will mean mathematics, physics, chemistry, statistics, botany, geology. Applied science will mean agriculture, forestry, BSc in wildlife. Then it will also include biochemistry, microbiology, biotechnology. It will also include veterinary science, animal husbandry, and then all the branches of engineering. And if you see the last 2 years toppers, Vidushi, who has been our student, Vaibhav, who has also been our student, they both are engineers. Vidushi has been a computer science graduate from Delhi College of Engineering, and Vaibhav has been a mechanical engineering graduate from NIT Suratkal. So because this exam is open only to science and engineering graduates, so competition is relatively less. Second thing, the main examination has got only one paper of general studies. Okay, so, and that general studies is also quite static, and it hardly asks any question based on opinion. So opinion based question nahi hote, that's very clear. So the questions are fairly straight, with suitable example, describe this, explain the powers of this. So that kind of questions are there. If you have prepared for your prelim really well, plus you have just accumulated some degree of advanced information, this is going to be more than enough to handle the GS in the main stage. Not only that, the UPSC does not even call this paper as GS in the main. it only calls it GK, general knowledge. Okay, so that's much easier, 300 marks paper, and in these 300 marks you have to answer question on history, polity, geography, science and environment, and some question from current affairs, but not analysis, not opinion based current affair. Next thing is, there is greater weightage being given to optional subject. There are two optional subjects, both of them need to be science based. You can take forestry or agriculture as one of the subject. No matter what is your background, you can make sense of these two subjects. You cannot take it together, keep in mind, that is no longer permissible by the UPSC. But any one subject you can take, we provide excellent guidance in both these subjects. One of the subject you can take it, and that will be taken care of. The second subject you have to take based on your comfort, based on your aptitude, and also some consideration of your scoring and all that. But that is a subject matter of another video. Okay, so the greater weightage is being given, and in the last few years, all the people who have got very nice rank in the Indian Forest Service exam, they all have been actually given that kind of performance because of very high score in their optional. So optional gets greater weightage, and if you are taking a subject like botany, agriculture and all, so this subject can very well be used in the civil service main examination. That's exactly what Vidushi has done a few years back, Vandita Rana had done, and a lot of candidates do it. Okay, last but not the least, the Indian Forest Service examination interview also has a very defined structure. Apart from your DAF related question like your background, your hobby, etc., job experience if any, apart from that, most of the question in IFS interview, they hover around environmental awareness, awareness about forestry practices, awareness about conservation, awareness about legislation related to wildlife, environment, forest, tribals, different national policies, different action plans, latest data, international developments and all that. So larger theme is to check your awareness of environmental issues, India and overseas. So that is by and large a defined structure, unlike the civil service interview where it can be very fluid. So to cut this long story short, I would like to tell you that if you are eligible, we have just now seen eligibility. So if you are eligible, do not think twice, just jump into the preparation. 1 year of systematic preparation can actually get you in the top 10 of Indian Forest Service exam. And as always, we at Evolution, myself personally, are here to guide you step by step and achieve that dream of getting a great rank in the Indian Forest Service exam. And mind it, 60-70% of your IFS preparation will lay a very solid foundation for your forthcoming attempt in the civil service. If you are someone who would also want to write the civil service exam, then this preparation won't go waste. 60-70% you can straight away transplant to your civil service preparation. So that is all about why you should be thinking of attempting and clearing the Indian Forest Service exam and become an Indian Forest Service officer. So that's all in this short video. I hope you found it helpful. Good luck and goodbye, and I will meet you again with another theme related to Indian Forest Service exam preparation. In that, I am going to cover how should you macro plan, the larger level plan for the Indian Forest Service examination, and then we will get into micro planning mode. But first, macro plan, that will come in our next video. Thank you very much.